This is a mask that I wore as a master's student at the MIT Media Lab when I was working on an art project. This art project would detect a face in a mirror and then display something like an animal or somebody who inspired me. So this project I called the Aspire Mirror. And as I was working on it, I realized that the software I was using had a hard time detecting my face. So when I put on the white mask, instead of struggling to be detected, it was flawless, and that was the moment I decided to start looking into why it was my face couldn't be detected, but this white mask could. My name is Joy Buolamwini, and I'm a public interest technologist. I started the Algorithmic Justice League when I realized we were entering the age of automation, overconfident, and underprepared. I look at the ways in which computers learn to detect, classify, and identify faces. I wanted to build tools to help researchers and practitioners code in a more inclusive way and also think through what they were developing with the full spectrum mindset from the design, development, and deployment of their system. So for example, one of our latest projects is gender shades that provided quantitative data about the failure rates of facial analysis technology from some of the leading tech companies on actually classifying the gender of somebody's face. And what we found in that study was these systems work better on male faces than female faces. They also work better on lighter skin than darker skin. And if you broke it down into different subgroups, lighter males had the best performance. No company we tested had an error rate of over 1%. Whereas if you look at darker skinned females, you had error rates as high as 35%. So to have a tech company failing on 1 in 3 women of color or 1 in 3 women with faces like mine, it's very concerning. If you're looking at most of the world, you're looking at women and people of color. So if you're narrowly focusing technology to serve a very homogeneous group and the technology is being developed by a homogeneous group, you're actually missing the majority of the world. One thing I've been really excited about with the gender shades research is that it's now being referenced by others to justify the need for more inclusive technology and also the need for more rigorous standards. So one of the areas in which the gender shades research has been used is an open letter to Axon's AI ethics board. Axon is a company that provides police departments with body-worn cameras, and they're considering putting facial recognition technology on the body-worn cameras. The gender shades research was used in an open letter stipulating specific steps that would need to be taken to make sure this technology isn't abused, and also stipulating areas it shouldn't be used in at all. So there aren't easy solutions, but there are definitely practices that can be involved in the design, development, and deployment of these technologies. I cannot just be a white mask and a shield on my own. We need everybody to add your perspectives and to add your voice so we can create a world where technology works well for all of us, not just some of us, and centers social change.